Here in Cincinnati, Ohio, everybody is ready for the National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. And I do mean everybody is getting ready for tonight's All-Star Game at the Crown in Cincinnati. Now, the NPSL All-Star Game is certainly a celebration of the players, but in the NPSL, it's always a celebration about the fans. The early arrivers getting a chance to meet and greet the stars of the National Professional Soccer League. You don't see this in every professional sport. The soccer players taking time out to meet their young fans and give them the much-coveted autographs. A big thrill for the fans and a lot of fun for the players. Tonight from the Crown in Cincinnati, Ohio, it is the 1998 National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. All-Stars from the American and National Conference of the National Professional Soccer League. Hello everyone, I'm Dave Johnson, and welcome to Fox Sports Net's coverage of the 1998 NPSL All-Star Game. Tonight, it's a celebration of the indoor version of the world's most popular game. The best players in the indoor game will be on display tonight, representing the two conferences of the NPSL, the National and American Conference. And you know, the NPSL is loaded with established stars who have dazzled crowds for over a decade. But the brightest has been Hector Marinero, the only player in indoor history to score 1,000 goals. He is the Michael Jordan of the NPSL, and to introduce you to him is an all-star in his own right and my broadcast partner, Art Kramer.
Okay, thanks, Dave. We're in the American Conference locker room with the NPSL's all-time leading scorer, Hector Marinero. And Hector, got to ask you, the all-star format, does it allow you to be a little bit more creative than you normally would?
I don't know about that. I think just you got all the players, all the best players in the league playing, so it's going to be an entertaining game, probably high scoring. And a lot of fun, and I always enjoy playing in them.
Can we look to see something special out of you tonight?
Like I said, playing with the best players, you know, you never know what's going to happen. Maybe a little bicycle kick if we can try.
All right. Hector, this is your sixth consecutive All-Star game. You've scored 1,000 goals in your career. At what point does this become boring, and how long can you continue doing it?
Well, you know, when it becomes boring, that'll be the time to hang it up, and it's still a lot of fun, and this is probably one of the highlights of the regular season is playing in this game, and get to play with the guys that usually are kicking you, so it's a lot of fun, and I've always enjoyed the All-Star game.
Okay, best of luck, Hector. Back up to you, Dave.
All right, thanks, Art Kramer in the locker room. You know, Hector Marinero really has been like the Michael Jordan of the NPSL, and like the NBA, the NPSL has a new galaxy of stars ready to burst onto the scene, including Joe Reiniger. He has really developed with the St. Louis Ambush, and the third member of our broadcast team, Greg Mace, is also in the locker room with Joe Reiniger.
Thanks, Dave. A lot of people do feel that Joe Reiniger could be the next superstar in the NPSL. Joe, a lot of people were making the comparison in the NBA All-Star game from Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan, the torch being passed. Do you feel like perhaps you are among the new breed of players that the torch can be passed to from Hector Marinero, or is that putting a lot of pressure on you?
I don't need to put any more pressure on myself. Hector's a great scorer, and he's been the leading scorer for years, and I expect him. He'll be around for several more years. So I just go out and try to do what I can for my team, and you know, I'm going to continue to do that hopefully for many years.
This is your second All-Star game. As you look over your season and the way your career has gone, what instincts, what things do you feel you still have to improve on to take it to that next level now?
You can ask anybody in this room, and they'll say it's my right foot. You know, I'm known for my hard left foot, and you know, for hitting three pointers. But I got a lot of work to do, and not only my right foot, but just on instincts, and you know, hopefully I'll continue to get better.
Anything spectacular planned for tonight? Wide open All-Star game?
It'll be wide open for myself. I just hope to stay as healthy as possible, and you know, we're going to work hard and try to get another win.
All right, Joe Reiniger, good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Joe Reiniger here in the National Conference locker room. Dave, back to you.
All right, thanks, Chris. Yes, indeed, Joe Reiniger already with a championship to his credit with the St. Louis Ambush. He looks for more in his great career ahead in the National Professional Soccer League. All right, back from the locker room is my broadcast partner and former four-time NPSL All-Star Art Kramer. So many great players to talk about, obviously, because it is an All-Star game. But for the American Conference, an interesting defender in Matt Knowles, who can also put in the back of the net.
Well, that's right, Dave. What's interesting about Matt Knowles is his ability to attack from the defense. And the National Conference forwards are are going to have to be aware of Matty Knowles attacking out of the back. He can slice you, he can dice you, he can, quite frankly, take you to the hole. And I tell you, those forwards better be defended here tonight.
All right, so often in All-Star games, we focus so much on the offense, but in the NPSL, we can't forget about the great goalkeepers. And a goalkeeper who's really coming of age from the Detroit Rockers, Brian Finnerty.
Yeah, the Goose, as he's affectionately known by his teammates in Detroit, is going to be one guy that's going to have to be concentrating on his game tonight. Traditionally, All-Star games are quite offensive, and all four goalies are going to have to come with their A game here tonight and be sharp in the nets.
All right, very simple. The best players in the indoor game are ready to perform for you tonight on the carpet here at the Crowd in Cincinnati. We are coming back with the starting lineups and opening kickoff as we continue with our coverage of the 1998 National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. The 1998 NPSL All-Star Game is brought to you by Ohio Lottery. Feel lucky today? By Eurosport, the fabled soccer traders. By Kendis, the official soccer ball of the NPSL. And by Stromden Supports, be like the pros. Back in the Crowd in Cincinnati, Ohio, the 1998 National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. The National All-Stars and the American All-Stars on display tonight from the 13-team National Professional Soccer League. The Canadian and American national anthems, of course, the NPSL represented in Canada by the Edmonton Drillers. Dave Johnson, Art Kramer back in Cincinnati. One of the stories for the National Conference All-Star team, we are about to 28, 29 games into the season. There are six players on the All-Star team from the National Conference injured. That could be a factor tonight for the National Conference with the head coach of the National Conference, Dale Duran, is Greg Mace. Greg?
Tonight with injuries, how's that going to affect your team in an all-star game in a big shooting situation?
Well, I think if the way we're going to have to play it is we're going to drop back a little bit, kind of save our legs. We only got one change at each position, and hopefully when the time comes where we have to pressure, it would probably be late in the quarters or if we get behind. So, you know, right now the first half we're going to concentrate on defense, maybe double team, and hopefully we can get a lead where we can keep at that same strategy.
And with that in mind, you should have an easy time getting these guys to play defense. Last year you held them to 14 points. In an all-star game, that's not a lot of points. You're a very defensive-minded coach.
It is, and I think the guys know we are a little shorthanded. I think the key is our defenders making sure if they do make the runs, they're smart runs, and our midfield cover up for us.
Darryl, thanks. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Darryl Duran with a unique situation here, playing a little shorthanded, Dave.
Thanks, Greg Mace. The 1997 NPSL All-Star Most Valuable Player was Darryl Duran of the St. Louis Ambush. The head coach of the American Conference is Dave McWilliams. In fact, he guided the American Conference to a victory in the All-Star Game in 1995. Our American Conference starters from the Milwaukee Wave, Victor Nogueira, Matt Knowles from Philadelphia, and Richard Chinabu from Harrisburg in the back, Hector Marinero, Zoran Karic, and Michael King, the forwards for the American Conference. For the National Conference, the veteran Jamie Swanner in goal, six-time goalkeeper of the year in the NPSL, Darryl Duran, Wes Wade from Kansas City, Kevin Ketters from Kansas City, Panamar Hedick from Detroit, and Joe Reiniger, we had a chance to visit with from the St. Louis Ambush. Our men in the middle tonight will be Joe Rudy and Julio Salas for the National Professional Soccer League. Steve Tsiomos, the director of officials in the NPSL.
And Dave, you heard Darryl talk about being a little bit shorthanded with the injuries, and in situations like this, when you are shorthanded, everybody else needs to step up and do just a little bit more than they normally would. And they're changing, as they said, in even numbers, five guys apiece. Look for them to really work hard tonight.
All right, the American Conference is in the blue jerseys, the National Conference in the red, and look for a competitive game. There have been many close All-Star games. Last year's game in Baltimore, very competitive. 2 years ago, the American beat the National in Wichita 16-15. Matt Knowles with a touch on the ball, but it's Joe Reiniger coming up with a steal for the American Conference. the back, Hector Marinaro, he is playing some defense, as he told you he might play some defense in this game.
Well, Dave, the Americans have four guys who have scored over 100 points on the season. Marinaro, Carriage, DeFlorio, and Sloan. The National Division only possesses one player, Joe Reiniger, that's scored over 100 points this season.
The National Conference coming on the attack, Wes Wade, blocked by Kevin Sloan of the American Conference. You get multiple scoring in the National Professional Soccer League. Every even-strength goal counts for 2 points, unless it's beyond the arc, the three-point arc, just like in the NBA, then it's a three-point goal, and they're also power plays and shootouts.
You heard Daryl say that they were going to drop back and make sure they get five behind the ball, and it's the American Conference is actually defending here early on.
Well, it was a strategy last year for the National Conference to employ a little more defense. Definitely a bit of a rivalry now really starting to develop between these conferences. Jamie Swanner with a long boot downfield. And the Magic Man, Palomar Hennick of the Detroit Rockers, putting it into the corner. Now, the National Conference staying on the attack. Nogueira swatting at it for the American Conference. He actually played for the National Conference last year. Now in transition, the American Conference, Matt Knowles.
And you see number 66. We talked about his ability to attack from the back. You saw Manny come forward. The Red did nice to get five behind the ball and cut off that counterattack.
George Fernandez on the ball, the player coach of the host Cincinnati Silverbacks in the American Conference. Now coming on the attack, Gino DeFlorio of the Silverbacks. DeFlorio trying to get a look on goal. His shot partially deflected. Now Fernandez, also from the Silverbacks, and he is fouled by Palomar Hennick. So we'll have a free kick coming up. As we look at Palomar Hennick, a longtime indoor soccer veteran.
One thing that Dave McWilliams said before the game was his team's ability to score free kicks was going to be a key in today's game. And here's their first opportunity from just outside the yellow line.
Restarts always dangerous in indoor and outdoor soccer. Omid Nemazia of the Philadelphia kicks it. That skims the glass into the crowd. And we'll have a goal kick coming up for the National Conference. We'll look at Omid Nemazia.
Nemazia's in a second All-Star game. He grew up in Provo, Utah. Not many professional players come from the Utah area.
Second consecutive All-Star appearance in the National Professional Soccer League. We're just underway, four 15-minute quarters. Look at the clock, we're about 12:52 left here in the first quarter of play. Pressure put on by Michael King of the American Conference, but now Joe Reiniger, and that glances off the scoreboard. That's where you see play stop, and that's with a violation. There's our scoreboard here at the Crown in Cincinnati.
Well, Joe told you he was known for his big left foot, and that time his left foot was a little too big as he knocked one all the way up off that Synergy scoreboard.
Zoran Karic into the net! Into the net! Goal! American Conference!
Well, it's a three-point goal as well, Dave. We just talked about Dave McWilliams, the coach of the American Conference, saying that his team would be dangerous on restarts. And look at Carriage. Just hammer that ball right through the legs of Jamie Swanner. And you saw Jamie put his hands up to tell his defenders he never saw the shot. He was screened. Let's see if the ball goes through the wall just under the left foot of Wes Wade. And Swanner never saw it.
3 points for Zoran Karic, the most valuable player in 1993 and 1995. And Zoran Karic got a three-point goal because it's outside the arc. The yellow line you can see on your screen outside the three-point arc. So the American Conference an early lead.
And that goal by Karic beats him the all-time leading scorer in All-Star games in NPSL with 29 points.
Now in transition for the National Conference, John Lemiatis of Montreal is stolen away by Hector Marinaro. And a break underway. Marinaro slotting it for Karic. Karic puts it back across the goal ball. And now Lemiatis escorts it to Jamie Swanner of the National Conference.
And I think Zoran expected Hector to continue his run through the box. It looked like Zoran was trying to chip it back to Hector. Hector kind of eased up on his run.
Again, as we told you, 3-0, as that was outside the arc. The free kick by Zoran Karic to make it 3-0 in favor. Well, Hector Marinaro, he's such a magic man on the ball.
Yeah, not only can he shoot the ball, he's the best ball striker in the league. He shows you his ability to pass. And Zoran, thinking that Hector was going to continue his run, chipped it back to the far post.
After a foul, a free kick by the National Conference, they work at far post, but Nogueira knocks it away to keep it away from Aaron Rasmussen of the Wichita Wings. Now Reiniger, there's that big left foot for the St. Louis Ambush star. Will be a goal kick coming up for the American Conference. Well, we've been kind of been hinting at the NPSL rules. Again, if you're new to the game, this is what makes it so exciting. Art Kramer, so many ways to score.
Yeah, just a normal goal during the run of play is 2 points. Outside that arc, which you just saw Karic shoot that shot from, is worth 3 points. Similar to the NBA, power play goals, 1 point, and also shootout goals, 1 point.
Here on Fox Sportsnet, we bring you the stars with Zoran Karic, Greg Mace. Greg?
Zorn, good quick start. You played in enough of these. What is the key to winning this game?
What's the key?
Yeah, just score more goals than the opposite team. So that's the bottom line.
Do you feel like you can take advantage of them tonight? They're playing a little shorthanded. Yeah, is that at all noticeable to you guys?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. It's a good game to watch, and you know, it's going to be a high-scoring game, and we just try to score more than they do. So,
you guys have always had a great. You got to go on. He's got to make a line change, so we'll let him out.
All right, Greg. So this is lots we don't see Greg Mace out on the carpet. We'll take Zorn Karic. He's got to get ready to go back on. But we're going to be bringing the stars of the NPSL tonight from Cincinnati.
Zorn grew up in Yugoslavia. Greg Mace should have told him Dobra, which means good in Yugoslavian, for that first goal.
The National Conference, they are the red. They trail the American Conference 3-0. Now here we see it. They're trying to work for an open passing lane here in the middle of the field, Art.
Yeah, the Reds just trying to build it up a little bit, try to draw the American division out a little bit.
Instead of breakaway here, DeFlorio on the ball. Slots it, Michael King, his shot is blocked by D'Annunzio, Bobby D'Annunzio of the National Conference, now in transition quickly to the National Conference. Eric Rasmussen, glances off the glass.
Well, Eric had a couple players streaking through the middle. Reiniger was one of them, and he elected to shoot. Just missed that one high to the left side.
Eric Rasmussen, interesting story, played professionally for a long time in Denmark. It's called Danish Dynamite. He plays for the Wichita Wings, and a big reason why the Wings are having a lot of success this year in the National Professional Soccer League.
And we talked about the firepower of the American Division, Dave. The National Division is going to have to beat the American in transition, which they did there. Quick transition created that three-on-one play, and you see Rasmussen elect to shoot. He had Reiniger at the far post, but too high for Joe to get his head on.
Adelmar Hedick on the restart. The National Conference with an effort that sails. It will be a goal kick coming up for the American Conference. So a chance there. We're looking to Zorn Karic, our goal scorer tonight. And there's Eric Rasmussen, played for Brøndby in Denmark, which is top of the Superliga in Denmark. So a European First Division player now playing here in the National Professional Soccer League. Nogueira, a veteran of the soccer game. Nogueira goes all the way back to the North American Soccer League, his playing days. Richard Chinapu knifing forward, started his career with the famed Cosmos. And it is the American Conference on the attack. And we have a whistle at the yellow line.
The time they call the foul on Padomar Hedick. He just got into the lane of the passer, the ball. Watch Pato not watch the ball, step into Pector's path there. Referee deemed it a little bit too flagrant.
He really wasn't playing the ball there, so that's why the whistle. Karic on the restart bends this one into the box. Now Matt Knowles steps up for the American Conference to keep the pressure on. 9:30 left here in the first quarter of this 1998 NPSL All-Star Game. And again, the goalkeeper gets so involved in the offense in indoor soccer.
And he's almost like a six attacker, so to speak, coming up over his yellow line and starting most of the play.
Oh, good ball, Marinero. With the shot! Coming through Richardson. It's in the net! It's in the net! Goal! Michael Richardson.
Well, Michael Richardson, the Red Rocket from the Milwaukee Wave. A great player off the board. So you saw that pass by Marinero to find the Red Rocket at the far post. And Michael, with that big left foot of his, we talked about Reiniger's left foot. This guy also has a nice left foot. Once again, a nice play by Richardson to pass and then move. As you see him move into the back post and finish it one time with the left foot.
American Conference with the early lead on the National Conference in the 1998 NPSL All-Star Game.
Yachty. You guys have gotten off to a real quick start here. A very good start for your conference.
Oh, yeah. I can't complain. You're up, what are we, up five? Yeah, we're up five. You know, it's still going to be a long game. You know, they're good. You know, we just got to come back defensively. Hope we can weather the storm a little bit at times and hope to counter on them.
This is your fifth All-Star game. What is the strategy coming in? You're not going to play a lot of defense. We saw, though, last year the National Conference playing a lot of good defense against you guys.
Yeah, I mean, if you can do that in an All-Star game, you got a good chance of winning it. And, you know, we're out to win the game today, so you'll be seeing us play just a little bit more defense.
All right, Michael, thanks. Good luck the rest of the way. Michael Richardson from the Milwaukee Way. Back up to you, David Arndt.
Thanks, Greg. And his dad, Peter Richardson, very involved in soccer in the Chicago area. Comes from a soccer family. A restart here for the National Conference, and this one gets by Reiniger, and now the American Conference in transition, quickly getting upfield and coming out of Swanner. And Swanner with the challenge. The American Conference keeping it alive with Bobby D'Annunzio coming up with it for the National.
And you saw there on the restart, players not that familiar with each other. They just weren't on the same page on that restart, and it led to a counterattack the other way.
Eric Rasmussen now, the Wichita Wings for the National Conference. They trail in this game 5-0 with 8:33 left here in the first quarter. Daryl Durant using the boards to get it to Swanner.
Coach Durant talked about dropping back early on, but when the team scores 5 points on you early, that kind of takes you out of that strategy and forces you to come out and pressure a little bit defensively. So let's look and see if the National doesn't start to pick up their pressure defensively to try to get back in this one.
American Conference in the blue, the National in the red. NPSL All-Star Game, DeFlorio pokes it ahead for Zoran Karic. That draws the attention of Jamie Swanner. As it glances off the glass, now again, the National Conference trying to work through transition. Wes Wade from Kansas City, he may play more in the attack tonight.
Yeah, Daryl told me that Wes, who was voted to the team as a defender, is going to push up and play the target man. Here he is coming down the left side.
And Wade with the shot by Victor Nogueira, his sure hands, and a quick distribution to Karic. Back to Marinero. And Marinero can't scissor it forward. Karic, though, digs in and helps out. Trying to get it to Chinapu, and if he ever unleashes, he's got a rifle of a shot for the American Conference. Now, Padomar Hennig, player coach of the Detroit Rockers, on the ball.
Going one-on-one against Richardson, and Pato and Michael Richardson were teammates in Chicago back in the early 90s.
Well, we said goalkeepers very busy as Jim Hesch coming forward for the American Conference.
And Jamie was lucky he didn't get called for a handball. Look at him come outside and pull those hands away, cover his head. And his teammate from St. Louis, Reiniger, was there to clean up the mess.
Quickly upfield, Zoran Karic glancing ahead of the follow-up by Richardson. That goes off the woodwork wide, and now the National Conference. Reiniger on the ball. Nice ball for his coach, Daryl Durant. Durant on the half volley. Mauro Biello of Montreal knocks it forward. Nice give and go. Reiniger, the save, Nogueira.
Oh, that's a world-class save that time by Victor Nogueira. Nice 1-2 that time by the National Division.
Nogueira, at the age of 38, still has the reflexes of guy 28. The goalkeeper for the American Conference. He was a goalkeeper last year for the National Conference. Milwaukee Wave switching conferences in a realignment in the offseason. Rasmussen tracks back. Instead, Matt Knowles comes up with it for the American Conference. And Jamie Swanner, he's had to cover a lot of real estate early.
And you saw Knowles once again trying to attack from the back, now hustling back defensively.
Zach Knowles slows down the attack. Kevin Kenner is trying to create. Leaves it for D'Annunzio. His left foot is cleared out by Fernandez. Now Hector Marinero, the Cleveland Crunch. Zoran Karic. Todd Rattie of the Edmonton Drillers gets a foot on it. And we have, I believe, an over-and-back violation against the American Conference. So a free kick for the National Conference. For the American Conference.
And just like in basketball, once that ball comes over the half line, it can't go back the yellow line. Look at the 1-2 this time. And Reiniger with the right foot that time. And Victor with a good hand save.
So again, it is like a backcourt violation of basketball. Once advanced by the offensive team over the yellow can't bring it back. And he shot! It's in the net, a goal again for the American Conference.
And that was Jim Hesch from the Harrisburg Heat. It was a nice ball played into the top of the box to Karic, and the Z-man with a nice little touch pass to Hesch. And Jimmy, playing in his first All-Star game, roofs one into the top of the net. First time off the volley, and Swanner basically had no chance. He was falling backwards. Here's a great look at it. You can see the forwards giving that pass down the center of the lane. And Hesch with good running off the ball. It's one thing I've really been impressed with here early on in this game, Dave, is the movement away from the ball to create options for the guy on the ball.
So the American Conference in the blue up 7-0. Wes Wade of Kansas City for the National Conference. On the ball, he creates using the boards. Now Daryl Durant
gets a touch. We have a whistle and a holding foul on the National Conference. So free kick for the American Conference. Greg Mace, back to you.
Amy scores his first goal. Jim Heck, what a thrill. Not only to be playing, you get to score a goal.
Yeah, it's great. I'm having so much fun. Just glad to be here.
This is very intense so far. I know this is only your first All-Star game, but these teams have come out flying. It's almost as intense as a regular season game.
Oh, yeah. From what they say, they didn't show too well last year. So Dave was telling us all day that we were coming to win. So that's why we're working hard.
All right, Jim, congratulations. First goal, first All-Star game. Jim Heck for the Harrisburg Heat.
Jim Heck, who started Syracuse University, now playing for the Harrisburg Heat. And boy, you know, mention that. Dave McWilliams, head coach of the American Conference, an All-Star game, but it sounds like he remembers last year the American Conference lost.
Well, I practiced with him yesterday, and that's what all Dave McWilliams was talking about, was winning this game. And you know, it's easy to say that in an All-Star game, and it's another thing to get players to come out and play strong defensively, but so far, he's been able to get his side to do just that.
Wait a minute, you practice with him and they're ahead right now?
I don't know what to tell you, Dave.
You got the touch. Gino DeFlorio on the ball for this American Conference. Marhedic pressured by Lance Johnson of the Baltimore Spirit. And now Jamie Swanner. And he's got a great arm. In fact, Swanner often gets involved in the offense. Has 15 assists for a goalkeeper. That's a lot.
Well, Swanner from St. Louis was once drafted by the St. Louis Cardinals back in the early 80s. Chose soccer instead of baseball.
A lot of soccer fans, glad he did. 4:06 left here in the first quarter. The American Conference in the blue up 7-0. National, Joe Reiniger trying to unleash that left foot. Reiniger creating. Now Todd Rattie of Edmonton puts it around the boards. Nogueira, great with his feet. And now Hector Marinaro, ball forward from Michael King. King, the shot. Rockets off the boards, and Reiniger tracks back.
That was a rocket. You saw Swanner pull that right hand back. Didn't want to get it pinched in along the boards as King really roped that left foot. And David, psychologically, the National Division needs to score the next goal to get back in this one. They're playing with 10 men. They're down 7-0 early. They desperately need to score the next one.
Now for the American Conference to get on the attack. Hector to Zorin. Hector coming through. And Todd Rattie does well in the box to control that, because that's a play Hector and Zorn work so often together as teammates for the Cleveland Crunch.
Well, they're the top tandem in the league as far as scoring goals. Both of them have been 1-2 for the last 5-6 years in scoring. And you see here Zorn working the boards. Actually, Todd Rattie working the boards.
And Jim Heck getting called for the foul. Too much of a spirited challenge on the part of the Harrisburg Heat. Rookie in the All-Star game. And it will be a kick in coming up. But, you know, the National Conference really having to make a lot of adjustments, a lot of injuries. All these players voted into the All-Star game and not able to play.
Well, you see three St. Louisans, Hundell, Moser, and Franklin McIntosh. Rudy Pickazinski came down with the flu, couldn't make it. So they're definitely shorthanded, and especially at the offensive end.
And it got so bad, Franklin McIntosh was actually a replacement, and he was injured. So a replacement for an injured player was injured. The National Conference trying to come back. Rasmussen puts a ball in the corner. Jim Heck, though, digging in there and now putting it back to his keeper, Victor Nogueira of the American Conference. The flick by Karich. And Richard Chinapu making a run. Richard, the player assistant coach of the Harrisburg Heat. Now quick transition for the National Conference.
And that's the arm of Swanner that you talked about earlier, Dave.
Kevin Sloan looking for Michael King. Swanner had that one read. Now Kevin Ketters ahead for Wes Wade. Leaves it for Marhedic. Marhedic now shoots the ricochet. Popcorns into the box.
Good run off the ball by Pato that time to get forward. Unfortunately for him, his left-footed shot was blocked by his own player.
Marinaro coming through, and Swanner able to scoop it up. The defender stayed with Kevin Sloan, who cut to the right, and Marinaro was left open. Michael Richardson coming onto the carpet. A 3-on-1. Richardson or his teammate Michael King saves Swanner. Marhedic pokes it away for the National Conference.
Nice save by Swanner. I think Kinger that time was trying to pass to Hector at the far post. Swanner read it well.
Matt Knowles creates space, shoots, foot save, Swanner.
Swanner!
Take a look at Jamie here. Diving across to take that pass from King away. King was trying to find Marinaro at the far post. Good reflexes that time by Jamie.
Now on the restart, Zorin Karich.
in the top of the arc for Marinero. Into traffic, Marinero stays with it. Now Richardson turns, saves Swatter. And now Todd Rattie tries to clear. Matt Knowles pitches it in. Rattie still under pressure. Gets some help from John Lemiatis. Lemiatis, a member of the Canadian National Outdoor Team.
We talked about the goalkeepers being the loneliest men out there, and you see Jamie Swatter making several good saves with his team down 7-0 already.
Oh, great pass to Richardson from... It's in the net! It's in the net! Richardson, the goal from Marinero!
Well, Michael Richardson, the Red Rocket from Milwaukee, with his second goal of the evening. Take another look. Good off the ball movement, as we talked about before. The Red defenders just standing around ball watching. Richardson picks the lower corner, and you saw Swanner's reaction after the goal, Dave. He almost resigning himself to the fact that his team is just not going to play a whole heck of a lot of defense in front of him here tonight.
We know in 9 All-Star games, Jamie Swatter has a points against average of about 12, which is actually pretty good in the All-Star game, but tonight, the American already with 9 points here in just the first quarter. The American in the blue, the National Conference in the red. And Swatter, who has been far too busy tonight, now will restart things on offense for the National Conference. Stepping up, though, with the steal. Now DeFlorio. DeFlorio from the Silverbacks, the home team. Marchetti comes in to help out. And now Darryl Durant.
And you see Durant, player coach from St. Louis, is one guy that possesses a lot of pride, Dave. Sure, after the first quarter, he's going to ask the guys, do we really want to be here?
Swatter to Wade. Wade, a defender, having to play a punt more tonight. Now Joe Weininger comes coasting through. The ricochet comes out, but it's cleared away by George Fernandez of the American Conference. Around the boards it goes by Petters. Nogueira knocks it away. Now Durant in the corner, and we have a whistle and a foul coming up on Jim Hesch of Harrisburg and the American Conference. So a free kick for the National. And this is a great situation for the National Conference with 18 seconds left.
Well, they need to get on track, and one way to do that in indoor soccer is off the restart. And I believe Darryl's going to take a timeout here to try to set something up this restart.
Victor Nogueira knows trouble is coming for the American Conference. You know, while we have a moment, let's update you on where we are right now, this portion of the National Professional Soccer League season. And it's been a very competitive and interesting season. The Philadelphia Kicks in first place. But, you know, Baltimore's still not out of a playoff spot. They're trying to make a late run. We continue with the American Conference, the Central Division, and this is a very competitive division with Milwaukee, Cleveland, and Cincinnati.
Yeah, it's a little bit surprising. Cleveland, who's been one of the best teams in the league, has dropped off a little bit this year. We're going to get a shootout one-on-one with the goalie. It's worth 1 point.
Eric Rasmussen of Wichita lobs it off the glass. Nogueira catches. So a shootout was awarded on that foul, and that's why we had the glare of Victor Nogueira. So we do have a penalty against the American Conference. Jim Hesch getting called for the penalty.
You see Rasmussen just trying to chip it up over Nogueira. A little too cute with that one. It's something you see in an All-Star game you might not normally see during the regular season.
So Hesch has a 2-point goal. Now a penalty. Now quickly on the restart. Weininger. The save is made by Nogueira. Now Lance Johnson of the American Conference tries to clear it.
That's the great thing about Victor Nogueira in goal, is he makes the difficult saves look easy.
Durant and Weininger off the glass. Again, the National Conference going for 1 point here. They had a 1-point opportunity on that shootout from Eric Rasmussen, and he was unable to convert. So Jim Hesch will still be in the penalty box as we start the second quarter for another minute 42. But right now, the National Conference searching for ways to come back. The American Conference with the lead, 9-0 in the NPSL All-Star Game. Dave Johnson, Art Kramer, Greg Bass back in Cincinnati. The American Conference with a 9-0 lead on the National Conference, and with the head coach of the National Conference, Darryl Durant, is Greg Bass. Greg?
Well, Darryl, I guess this is one of your greatest coaching challenges, I guess you could call it at this point, playing shorthanded down 9-0.
I mean, we're doing exactly opposite of what I wanted to do. I wanted to try and get on top. So you're going to see us now. We're going to have to try and back into it, break the ice with a goal here, hopefully on the power play, and then we're going to have to go a little high pressure to try and get some quick counterattacks.
All right, thanks, Darryl. Let's get back on the field. Back upstairs to David.
All right, thanks. And Greg Mesa, Jim Hesch is in the penalty box for the American Conference. So the National Conference does have a power play for the next minute 42. That's the first time in NPSL All-Star history there's been a shutout in a quarter. So the National Conference being shut out 9-0. The fewest points have been 2 prior to this. And the American Conference in the blue, the National in the red.
And it's no surprise the guy that shut him out was Victor Nogueira.
Well, he played, of course, for the National Conference last year, which is so stifling when the American Conference was trying to win last year.
Well, he's regarded by many as the best indoor goalkeeper in the world, as he's done quite well in many of the futsal five-a-side tournaments in Brazil.
Indeed, a world-class player. He started his career back in 79 in North American Soccer League. The American Conference in the red on the attack on the power play. Kevin Ketters on the ball. About a minute and 5 left, beginning in the NPSL scoring. If the American Conference scores here, it's worth 1 point. Kevin Sloan putting the pressure on, and Lance Johnson clearing for the American Conference.
Well, the Nationals got about 50 seconds left on this power play to make a change. Pato Marchetti comes out to run it.
Power play continues. Eric Rasmussen spins around. Richardson on him for the American Conference. 41 seconds left on the power play. Into the corner, Ketters. The centering pass is cleared away. You're watching Fox Sports Ohio's coverage of Fox Sports Net of the 1998 NPSL All-Star Game. Rasmussen for Reitinger. He heads it down, and George Fernandez has to clear it away for the American Conference. Reitinger, the left-footed shot, and Sloan comes up with a steal and knocks it away. 15 seconds left. The American Conference has weathered the storm on this power play very well.
One thing you got to be careful about with the man advantage is not getting scored on right after the power play ends, Dave, because then it would be worth 2 points.
And you've used up so much energy defending the power play. Teams at even strength as Jim Hesch returns to the carpet. He was whistled for the foul that resulted in the shootout attempt by the American Conference. Eric Rasmussen unable to convert. So back to even strength. And now Hesch quickly puts it on the corner, and Swanner has to swat on it. Hesch stays with him. Michael King. George Fernandez now. He's at the hometown Silverbacks. Hesch in the corner. Good ball for King. It's in the net! It's in the net! It's in the net! A goal, Michael King!
Well, just a textbook goal. A great pass that time by Hesch, and great off the ball running by Michael King. To find himself free, Hesch splits 1, 2, 3 defenders, and Kinger with the instep drive into the upper corner. Swanner had no chance.
Again, great cross.
Off the ball running by King is impressive to find himself free.
2-point goal by Michael King. Makes it 11-0. National Conference trying to advance forward. Look at Demario Biello of the Montreal Impact. And I believe we have a timeout on the floor.
It looks like it's going to be another shootout.
So the foul whistled by Julio Salas. Omi Namazi will go to the box for 2 minutes on the foul. So now a shootout situation here for the National Conference. They're down 11-0. Joe Reitinger 1-on-1 against Victor Nogueira for 1 point.
And you'd expect Reitinger, Dave, to just take one touch and fire away with that big left foot.
Reitinger. There's the one touch. There's the foot. There's the goal. It's in the net. And the National Conference is on the board.
Well, I'm a little surprised that Victor didn't come out a little bit stronger and try to cut down the angle, but he probably didn't want to get too close to that cannon of a left foot. Reitinger, one touch, looks up, picks his spot, and just bends one inside the near post. And I'm sure Victor didn't expect to come out tonight and have to save too many shootouts. An All-Star game, you don't traditionally see a lot of penalties.
Well, we've seen two in the past 5 minutes. So Joe Reitinger, the emerging star in the NPSL, in his fifth season now, and he gets a goal. A shootout goal worth 1 point. And now Wes Wade skims off Nogueira's fingertips. Richardson heads it forward. Now, the National Conference will maintain with a minute 40 left here on the power play. The team in the red has the man advantage.
And Coach Durant did have the option of taking the penalty or declining the penalty, Dave. Sometimes later in the game, when you need 2 and 3 pointers, you'll decline that penalty, but still too early to do that.
They want to get 1 point at a time. Coming through, Ketters, the blast. Ricochets off the board. And Lance Johnson of the Baltimore Spirit and the American Conference clears. So a minute 13 left on the power play, the man advantage for the American Conference. Pardon me, the National Conference in the red, coming through Rasmussen.
And last power play, it was Pato Marchetti running the quarterback position. This time it's Wes Wade, you see on the ball right there. So Darryl changing up his personnel a little bit.
Rasmussen, the right-handed save by the Garrett. Ketters now. Reiniger. Unlocks.
Impressive by Nagira to get his hand on it, and more impressive to keep it out of the goal.
Poked away by Jim Hesch. Wes Wade will control it. Eric Rasmussen, we've seen him on a lot of the ball in this power play. He's on the ball now. He had 6 assists and a quarter in an NPSL regular season game. To Wade, it's into the net! It's into the net! A goal from Eric Rasmussen to Wes Wade! So a one-point goal makes it American Conference 11, National Conference 2, but Nagara really did well on this power play.
Yeah, look at the right-handed save by Victor. Shows a lot of strength to keep that ball out of the goal, but if you don't score high, you might as well try going low. And that time, right past Victor's right foot, Wes Wade moving up to forward tonight because of the injuries, gets on the board.
And the assist from Eric Rasmussen from the Wichita Wings. He's played in 12 games and already has 53 points for the Wichita Wings. So
credit to Rand with a nice little run through the box and take his defender with him to allow that space for Wade.
So that'll give the National Conference some confidence at this point. Albeit they're down by 9 points. The National Conference in the red, the American Conference in the blue. Richard Chinapu.
Well, this is where the scoring system comes into play, Dave. Right now, if they can score a 3-pointer, the National Conference can get themselves right back in the game. People think, hey, 11-2, it's a blowout, but a couple 3-pointers and you're right back in it.
It's the beauty of indoor soccer. It's crazy. Zoran Karic trying to play the ball to Marinero. Mauro Biello coming up with the interception. Great ball by Biello for Hadamar Henning. But Richard Chinapu, two veterans tangling, and Chinapu winning that 1v1 situation. Now Marinero looking for Karic. Chinapu now controls it to Kevin Sloan. Sloan, great space, the shot, swatter, the save, the follow, and again, Karic another chance. Now the National Conference, or Henning for Rasmussen in transition. Rasmussen creates some space, then denied by Matt Knowles. Back heel, Marhenik the shot. Good defense by the American Conference to get finally behind the ball.
It really was, and good individual technique that time by Rasmussen, trying to find space at the top of the box. We talked about Nagara making some great saves, Dave. This time it was Jamie Swanner. Not the initial shot, but a little bit later on Carriage, he stuck out that right hand. See Sloan there, Swanner's first save. Chinapu misses wide, and then this save right there with the best one on Karic.
Back to live action in the American Conference. Karic playing it back to Michael Richardson. American Conference in the blue with the 11-2 lead. We're at the Crown in Cincinnati, the 1998 NPSL All-Star Game on Fox Sports Ohio on Fox Sports Net.
And with this 11-2 lead, Dave, they can afford to be patient, possess the ball a little bit, make the National Division, who only have 10 field players, make them chase you a little bit. Darryl still electing to sit back and try to counterattack, but you can only do that so long when you're down by 9 points.
The flick by King for Richardson, the chest bump. King the header, now DeFlorio the shot. That would have used every skill in soccer had that gone in the net.
It's a good job by Gino to get all the way around that shot and put it just over the top of the goal. It didn't look like he could hit the goal from where he was.
Can't use your hands, but then show the creativity of soccer on that sequence. Darryl Durand, long ball for Reiniger, the National Conference. Now Rasmussen. Todd Rattie of the Edmonton Drillers. Into the corner for Biello. Does well to trap it on the high ricochet, but he's double-teamed.
And the National Division not presenting the guy on the ball enough options by running off the ball. The ball's going into the corners, but there's no one there in support for the target man to lay it off to.
And Giannis plays it to Reiniger. Their Canadian presence on the field right now, Todd Rattie, Lemionis, and Biello. Biello trapping, but King coming back and putting it back to the keeper. And we'll have an over-and-back violation, so it will be a free kick coming up here for the National Conference.
Watch that ball comes over the yellow line, David. Can't go back over. It's an over-and-back, similar to basketball.
King not necessarily aware of where he was on the field when he played that. Reiniger coming through. to Ketters, the shot, the save in traffic, the follow, Reitinger, foot save, Madeira.
Well, Victor's made about 6 or 7 foot saves in this first half.
Rasmussen now on the ball, and Michael King on defense. The American Conference win the ball. Gino DeFlorio of the Cincinnati Silverbacks. Soren Karich. Karich plays it for Kevin Sloan. Sloan dancing, but pressured. Spins off the carpet. Karich, the rifle. And now, in traffic, the National not able to clear. Sloan will put it back to midfield.
Good play by the Americans to isolate Zoran Karic one-on-one in the corner to allow him to take that defender on the dribble. Swanner had to come up with a good save.
DeFlorio, Karic the header. Having some trouble at midfield now, Marhedic. Marhedic for the National Conference. He's 1-on-3, he likes the odds. Marhedic! Marhedic now needs support. Marhedic, Fernandez gets in his way. Marhedic again, but at that point too winded to get anything spice on it.
The National Division too slow to come in support of Pato. He ran for 10 seconds with the ball, and you didn't see a red jersey in your picture.
Zoran Karic. Richardson blasted. That's blocked. Now in transition, Joe Reitinger slotting the ball. Rattie the shot. Skims off the board. And the American Conference will control. 5:46 left here in the first half. The American with 11-2 lead and having it come out of Swan. Marinaro, it's into the net! It's into the net! Goal, Hector!
Well, a great first touch that time by Hector Marinaro to set himself. And Jamie Swanner asking his defenders, where the heck are you? A nice ball played out of the back that time by Zoran Karic. And watch Hector just reach for this ball, take it down with a beautiful first touch, and slide it under the sliding Swanner.
Hector Marinaro, the American Conference, with a 13-2 lead on the National Conference. Dave Johnson, Art Kramer back in Cincinnati, and Art Kramer 13-2 the score. American with a big edge.
That's right, and this time the National Division got caught ball watching. All the defenders focusing their eyes on the ball, not watching the runner, who's Marinaro, get in behind him. Cardinal sin of a defender, Dave, letting it forward in behind you. And that time Hector snuck in, made a great first touch. And that's why he scored 1,000 goals in his career.
We talked about the outset. He really has been like the Michael Jordan of the NPSL. A lot of great stars, but certainly Hector Marinaro probably top of the class just if you look at the numbers. And the flair of creativity is given this sport. 5:21 left here in the first half. But Hector, part of what they call the dynamic duo in Cleveland, who gets a lot of help from Zoran Karic. Michael King now coming forward for the American Conference. They look for more.
A big goal earlier in the game by Michael King. He'd gone 3 straight games in Milwaukee without scoring a goal, so brings himself out of a little mini slump he's been in.
The pressure on is Jim Heskin storming through. Swatters out of his box, and he has to clear it, as we almost saw that Zorn-Hector combination we alluded to. And Jim Hesch, the first-time All-Star from Harrisburg, was almost there for the follow-up after the Hector-Zorn connection did not connect.
We heard Hesch say in the opening he's just happy to be here, just out with these All-Star players. He's doing quite well. He's got a goal. He's got an assist. He's also picked up a penalty.
That's right. He's done the cycle tonight. Jim Hesch, great story for the Harrisburg Heat. He's really worked hard to develop a career in indoor soccer. Went through a tough season last year with the Columbus Invaders, but now with Harrisburg. A free kick for the American Conference. The ball that Matt Knowles, the save Swanner. Kevin Sloan now. Sloan puts it through the box, and Marinaro was there for the header, just whistled by too quickly. Sloan, though, creates the space. And the American Conference in the blue stays on the attack. Kevin Sloan.
One of the keys for the National Day was going to be how well they did transition. And so far, the American team is beating them in both ends of the transition, from defense to offense and from offense to defense.
Reiniger coming up with the steal for the National Conference. Now Wade will make the run, but the American Conference does well to get the numbers back. And Matt Knowles with the steal. Now Kerrich, instead it's a two-on-one forming here.
And you see the American beating the National in transition.
Knowles! Oh! You're right on it, Artie, though. It's a two-on-one.
Creating numbers for your team, a lot has to do with how much energy and effort you put into the run. And it's that guy that makes that little extra effort to get forward creates the numbers advantage for his team.
Marhenik now for Eric Rasmussen. The Wichita Wings. Rasmussen, he's drawn two defenders. He needs support. Instead, the American Conference.
And look at that quick transition by Chinapu down the right side to create space for King.
King instead puts it back. Mazi, Chinapu, it's in the net! It's in the net! Richard Chinapu, 41 years young.
Well, that's great because Chinapu made an unselfish run down the right side to create the space, kept working himself to find space in the box, put it through D'Annunzio's legs, and Richard Chinapu, the oldest player in this All-Star game at 41 years old, still going strong.
Richard Chinapu, we had lunch with him today. He's 41 years young. He looks great. The player assistant coach gets started his career with the Cosmos. So
you see Dave McWilliams talking to Richard. He introduced all the players from his respective side, and he introduced Richard last, he said, because he was older than the coach.
You know, funny thing about it, Chinapu thought he was being a wise guy, but Dave McWilliams quickly said, no, that's out of respect.
And I can tell you, Richard Chinapu has had the respect of the players in many leagues for a lot of years.
The assistant coach to Jim Callahan of the Harrisburg Heat. Now the National Conference in the red. Marhenik, it's almost like 1-on-4. He's got help on the right wing. Now D'Annunzio comes up, and Marhenik just puts it into traffic. Richardson now, and again the transition game. This is a 3-on-2 for the American Conference. Swatter comes out to try to deny the angle as Kerrich was waiting to poach a goal. Marinaro to Zord. Kerrich's a shot. That's off Todd Bertilli of the Edmonton Drillers.
As a player, it's always fun to play when you've got a big lead. You're confident. You know there's not a lot of pressure. You can afford to knock the ball around and be patient.
Kerrich, watch the moves. The silkiness. Lance Johnson decides to have a go.
And you can tell the American Conference players are just having fun right now with this big lead.
15-2. The American Conference leads the National Conference. Let's go down to Greg Mace.
Well, Richard, you guys are having a lot of fun out there. Is it almost too much fun at this point with the big lead?
I think we're playing extremely well. We're working both sides of the floor. You have terrific players up front who can finish and who can really make good passes. I think it's unfair on the national side that the national side don't have the amount of players that we have. We're kind of taking it. Ball and move and you'll get it back.
And yet another goal, and send it back upstairs as they continue to pile on the lead here.
Thanks, Greg. Michael King with the goal from the Milwaukee Wave.
And once again, look at the movement after the pass. Kinger with a nice 1-2, and he just buries one into the lower corner.
A give and go, and Michael King getting the go. He gets the goal. It's 17-2, the American Conference.
And the Milwaukee connection, Michael King and Michael Richardson have combined for 4 goals here in the first half for the American division.
Well, now with a 17-2 lead, the American Conference close to tying the record for points and a half in an All-Star game. That record was set by the American Conference back in 1995 when Dave McWilliams coached him to victory in Buffalo. They have a whistle and a foul. And we may have another shootout there coming up. We'll get to that in a moment. But coming up at halftime, our Wall Power NPSL All-Star Halftime. We will have rock and roll highlights from Common Sense. The NPSL expands news about that. And you're going to go inside the locker rooms. That's coming up at halftime, our Wall Power NPSL All-Star Halftime here on Fox Sports Ohio on Fox Sports Net. We look at Eric Rasmussen. And we do have a penalty.
See Wes Wade tell the referees, look at the score, it's 17-2, giving us a penalty, and it's going to be Matty Knowles, the guy that we talked about, his ability to attack from the back. He's going to show us some of his one-on-one skills. Let's see what happened here down in the corner. Wade and Knowles, and Wade just came with the shoulder and boarded him. And now Knowles is a guy that likes to take the goalie on the dribble. Let's see if he shoots first time or tries to cut.
1v1 here for 1 point. Matt Knowles, Swatter comes out. Knowles cuts. Scores! It's in the net. Well, with a minute two left here in the half, that'll make it 18-2, American Cup.
I'm sure Jamie Swiner has seen Matt Knowles on the shootout before, but when you cut the ball that well and that tight, there's not a whole lot that a goalie can do. And that time, Knowles, with a beautiful cut move to his left, fakes the shot. You see Swiner turn a little bit, and that allowed Knowles to have enough time to stick it right off that delta sign.
You know, it's not often you see a shootout penalty from that deep in the defensive end, but instead that was the call, and the American Cowboys with another advantage on the power play. They go far post, and getting up with it is Swatter, as Kevin Sloan was looking to knock in the Zorin carriage feed. Now in transition, Biello tries to control it. Now Darryl Durant jumps in. Biello cuts the goal. Durant can't find him. As again, the defense. Matt Knowles got back and prevented the pass to Biello, who was wide open in the box. Now, guess what? The American in transition. Marinaro trying to slot it for DeFlorio. 27 seconds left.
This is a potent power play for the American division. You've got Marinaro, Carriage, and Knowles in the back. DeFlorio and Sloan up front. Almost 400 or 500 points between those five guys on the season.
Knowles, nice through. Now Zorin Carriage, 7 seconds left. Knowles the blast. 3 seconds, DeFlorio has a go. Darryl Durant controls. And the American Conference 1 point shy of an all-star record. At halftime, the American Conference out to a big lead, 18-10 on the National Conference. We're coming back with the Wall Power NPSL halftime. It's time now for the NPSL All-Star Halftime, brought to you by Wall Power, an exclusive publication of indoor soccer. 1-888-489-8153 for your Wall Power subscription. Back in Cincinnati at the Crown, our halftime score of the American Conference with an 18-2 lead on the National Conference. And the American Conference only 1 point shy of an All-Star record that they set three seasons ago in 1995. And indeed, maybe the fact the National down to 10 players because of injuries showing a little bit here.
Yeah, now you got to give credit to the Milwaukee boys, Richardson and King with 2 goals apiece, and Victor Nogueira, I thought, was exceptionally sharp in the nets for the American Conference.
He could certainly frustrate opponents, and tonight his opponent being the National Conference. Downstairs with the head coach of the American Conference, Dave McWilliams, is Greg Mace. Greg?
Well, Davey, at this point, what do you have to guard against? It almost looks like you guys are just shooting at will out there. Are you taking advantage of their lack of personnel?
No, I think give our guys credit. I think we made a plan to make sure that we were solid defensively, and the goals will come if you play solid defense, and the guys have done that, and they executed real well.
What now at this point do you tell these guys at halftime that they have to guard against? Because you know that Durant and these guys have a lot of pride. They're not going to just sit back and let you guys score.
For sure. You just mentioned it. Pride is a big factor, and we just got to make sure that we're not complacent. We just got to go out there with the same intensity, same work rate, and we'll do fine.
How much of a rivalry do you feel there really is between the two conferences? In the regular season, of course, you guys play each other a lot. But we always see a very intense fourth quarter in this All-Star game.
For sure. I think, as you say, you mentioned earlier, pride's a big factor in both sides. There's a lot of pride in these guys. They take pride in what they do, and it's going to be a big factor the second half.
We have a lot of people watching on Fox Sportsnet for the first time, who are seeing indoor soccer for the first time. From a coach's perspective, what do you tell the first-time viewer what indoor soccer is like? What should they be appreciating about this game?
Well, I think the running off the ball. I think Jimmy Hesch and Michael King teamed up for some unbelievable goals, and just the ability of these guys to control the ball and knock the ball, and it's enjoyable to watch.
Dave, we'll let you get back in the locker room. Thanks a lot.
Great, thanks.
Dave McWilliams, the coach here of the American Conference, and he's still going to be pretty intense coming out here. But I really noticed this is my fourth time on the bench for an All-Star game. We have a lot more intensity, I think, in the first half than we've ever seen before, even though we have a high-scoring game. So we'll see if the other conference, the National Conference, can now come back. And as Davey said, they've still got a lot of pride. These guys are going to come out and even score some more goals if they can. Dave?
All right, Greg, indeed, full credit to the American Conference. They move well without the ball, and they play good defense, and that's the reason for the 18-2 advantage. And we did mention the personnel situation, but really you have to give the credit to the American Conference for the things we just mentioned.
Yeah, you heard him talk about the off-the-ball running. It has been impressive for young players. When the ball's around them, yeah, they want to play, but it's quite often what the player does off the ball, the movement off the ball, that can create scoring chances. And if there's young players out there watching today, they can really watch that off the ball running.
All right, well, Virgin recording artist Common Sense has an uncommon flair for stirring up fun, a little bit like the NPSL. In fact, they bridge the gap between reggae, rock, funk, and soul. And indoor soccer also bridges the gap between several sports, and tonight we put them both together. Recording artists, Common Sense, the message to the National Conference, never give up. Still coming up on our Wall Power Halftime, the NBSL expands, and we're going to take you inside the locker room as we continue from the Crown in Cincinnati, Ohio. Why never give up for the National Conference? The American Conference has the lead at the halftime, 18-2. The American Conference with the advantage. The National Conference in the locker room right now making the plans. And maybe they'll have more talent than these guys probably do on the soccer pitch. They're great cheerleaders, but we've got more coming up at halftime. Back in Cincinnati at the Wall Power halftime. The American All-Stars with the 18-2 advantage on the National All-Stars in the 1998 National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game, hosted by the Cincinnati Silverbacks. And there's Max Stabber, the gorilla, the mascot for the Cincinnati Silverbacks. And the Silverbacks, a relatively new franchise, having success here in the National Professional Soccer League, and things always changing in the NPSL. In fact, today, in USA Today, where the NPSL may be growing, and the National Professional Soccer League expected to announce the addition of the Indianapolis Twisters, Indiana Twisters, of the Continental Indoor Soccer League. And with me now to perhaps clarify more on that is the commissioner of the NPSL, Steve Paxos. The NPSL now in its 14th season. And what light can you shed on that? We saw that in USA Today, that the Indiana Twisters may be joining the NPSL.
That's a very good rumor. I'm very excited in the NPSL. I'm going to visit Indianapolis tomorrow to tour the facilities. There's an application pending. We're hoping to act on it very soon.
So you're looking at possible expansion, and we know that the Continental Indoor Soccer League, the Summer League, going out of business, but with a lot of franchises that have expressed an interest in continuing in the game of indoor soccer, might we see some more franchises from the Continental Indoor Soccer League?
Well, let me tell you that the talk around the league right now in the country is expansion. There's a number of teams from the XESL League that have been in contact with us. We're in negotiations right now. We're hoping to resolve all the problems and reach an agreement, and you could possibly see the NPSL be coast to coast overnight.
Well, that would certainly be a positive for the NPSL, and you started in that expansion with the addition of the Edmonton Drillers, so it's not even coast to, it's not only coast to coast, it's also North American.
North American into Canada, you know, there's a possibility we might even go south into Mexico.
So it's certainly a good possibility, and the NPSL, the attendance, way up now in your 14th season. Why do you think there's been such a dramatic increase this season?
Well, I think it's the product. You've seen what a great first half we had. Speaks volumes for the players and the league, and for the first time in the history of the league, we crossed the 1 million mark in the earliest point. And as long as we continue to provide what the fan is looking for, the NPSL's got a bright future.
All right, Commissioner Steve Paxos,
thank you,
we appreciate the time, and good luck with all your ventures in the National Professional Soccer League. Steve Paxos, guiding the NPSL now in its 14th season. Well, we promised you, Commissioner, we're going to take him inside the locker room. Not every fan gets to do this. We're going to take him inside the locker rooms. Let's go inside the locker rooms here at the NPSL All-Star Game.
And we're here with Jamie Swanner, who did not have a fun time, but you still have a good attitude about it. I mean, you made a lot of great saves, and they still got 18 points on you.
How about that? You know, you look here, you come out to play hard. You know you're going to face a lot of shots. You know it's going to be like that. But, man, I'm tired.
Well, is it your lack of personnel? You're playing shorthanded. I mean, you got guys who are out going out every couple seconds on a shift.
Yeah, it's tough. You know, usually we can change in threes. Now we're in twos and sometimes one, double shifting back and forth. It's tough, but, you know, you got to give them credit. This is a great fan sport game here. And all the points, fans got to love it.
All right, what did Daryl Durant say to these guys? That's Wes Wade saying hi to his mom. What did Daryl say to you guys?
Well, we got down and prayed. Does that do anything?
That counts.
He just said, you know, we got to suck it up a little bit. It's going to be tough second half. You know, we are shorthanded, but the bottom line is, you know, we're going to fight to the end.
All right, a lot of pride on this team. Jamie Swanner, thanks a lot.
Thanks.
All right, Jamie will sit down here in the second half. Brian Finnerty will go in. Dave, we'll see what happens. As we said, these guys have a lot of pride, and we'll see if they can come back.
All right, thanks, Greg Mace. In fact, the American Conference and the National Conference back on the floor, getting set for the second half. 18-10 the score. The American with the lead. But the National Conference, they heard the message from Common Sense. Never give up.
Today's the day. My ticket, I got winning on my mind. So count me in, I'll play along. I'll be a winner before too long. Gonna be lucky today. Yes, I feel lucky today. Do you feel lucky today? Lucky today, lucky today.
Score a goal with the NPSL. Apply today for your official NPSL MasterCard. Call 1-800-523-7666. Get your favorite team's logo on your official NPSL credit card. 1-800-523-7666. It's in the net, and it's all here. The NPSL official guided record book. Profiles of every NPSL team and a complete history of the NPSL. Only $20, including shipping and handling. 1-330-455-4625.
In today's multicultural
most points of the half go back to Buffalo, 1995. The American Conference with the 19. We had 18 tonight. Interesting, both teams coached by Dave McWilliams.
And many people may look at the score right now, Dave, and say this game's over. It's 18-2 at the half. Milwaukee earlier this season was down 17-3 at Cleveland at the half, came back and won the game 28-23.
Oh, no, really, it's one of the great selling points of the multiple scoring system in indoor soccer. You know, the National Conference is down 18-2, but they've won the great three-point goal scorers in Joe Reinger. He has 11 three-point goals on the season, so they can use that big left foot here in the second half. The National Conference in the red jerseys, and right away they are on the attack. And in goal is Pete Pappas of the Philadelphia Kicks for the American Conference, and the National Conference has Brian Finnerty of the Detroit Rockers. They switch goalkeepers at the half. Zorin Kerich, ricochet off the glass. Just underway third quarter, in four 15-minute quarters in the NPSL. Knowles to Marinero. Hard ricochet, and now D'Annunzio. Long ball looking for Wes Wade. He slips behind Knowles, but Knowles recovers.
And Wes Wade had just come out of the box after the penalty was over.
Wade, D'Annunzio, save! Pete Pappas! And Pappas gets down again to scoop it up. Pappas having a great year with the Philadelphia Kicks, a 10.92 points against average.
And it's nice to come on and get that first save under your belt. And you saw Pappas that time rob Bobby D'Annunzio after Wade had sent him through. And watch Petey come sliding out with the right hand to Rob D'Annunzio. And that would have been a big goal for the national team to come out and start the second half and get one right off the bat.
Michael Richardson on the ball now for the American Conference from the Milwaukee Wave. Kerich marked by Kevin Kenners.
Talked about Pete Pappas. He's a replacement for Cincinnati goalkeeper Carlos Pena, who was voted to the All-Star team by the players. I know a lot of the fans here in Cincinnati tonight would have loved to see Carlos in this game.
Jim Hesch from the Harrisburg Heat on the ball for the American Conference. Richard Chinapu has also scored tonight, of course, scoring pretty well distributed with the 18-2 lead for the team in the blue, the American Conference. Now, the National Conference in transition. This is Joe Reiniger. Rasmussen, very creative player, and he shows it there. Rasmussen, it's in the net! It's in the net! A goal! National Conference!
Well, it's a start, Dave, and it was a good play by Rasmussen to use his body to shield off the defender. Look at the nice, tight turn. He's got King, shields him off, and then just a quick trigger. Watch him pull this trigger here. And Pappas got caught leaning to his left. A good play by Rasmussen to use his body to shield off the defender.
Rasmussen, a replacement for Kim Rundgren of the Wichita Wings. And Rasmussen again with the 53 points in only 12 games. He really has stormed on the season, on the scene in the NPSL. Again, played in the Danish First Division with Brøndby.
It's really strange to be in an All-Star game without Kim Rundgren. Kim has been an All-Star 15, 16 years in a row, going back to the MIFL days.
And a great ambassador for the sport, and of course, and now with Wichita Wings, Wes Wade for the National Conference. Nice ball forward, Mauro Biello. Biello crosses it, far post, and Rasmussen again was there. So better ball movement by the National Conference.
Well, had the National scored there, I wouldn't have been surprised to see David Williams take a timeout, giving up two early goals. But the National Conference has to finish your chances to get back into this one.
Wimbianis, his shot, and getting down to the carpet. Omid Damasi to make the block for the Philadelphia Kicks. Well, Jamie Swatter, they need to give the goalkeepers the rest of the second half they played in the first half.
But you see Swatter, though, he's working the door, he's talking to his teammates, making sure the changes are crisp and tight.
They're from one of the great college programs in this country, the Clemson Tigers. Reiniger, the blast. Reiniger recovers. Kenner's shooting nicely using the walls to get back to Brian Finnerty.
And Swanner on the bench for the National probably wondering, where was this play in the first half?
That's right. Now coming through D'Annunzio, and he's held by Namazi, and that'll be a two-minute penalty and a shootout coming up for the National Conference. Well, the fabled soccer traders. Of course, Eurosport, we'll get to that in a moment.
And watch the penalty here. Namazi just grabbed the jersey of D'Annunzio, pull him down. Now, Paolo Marchetti's going to take a shootout, Dave. Wouldn't be surprised to see Duran decline the penalty after the shootout because he's down by 14 points here in the second half. Let's take a look. Go back. First, we'll watch Pato take the shootout.
18-4 the score. The National Conference down by 14, trying to get back. Marhedic 1v1 against Pete Pappas. Marhedic! Oh! They call that, I believe, a nutmeg.
Well, they call Pato the magic man. He can score them on you any way he likes. And this time, he picks the five hole and goes through Pappas' legs. Pappas says, you're going left, you're going right. Oh, you're going right through my legs.
All right, it's 18-5, but it looks like they do not decline the power play. So now, it will be the National Conference in the red with the one-man advantage for the next 2 minutes. But again, if they score during that two-minute span, it's only worth 1 point.
And Darryl thought about declining the penalty. I saw him down there discussing it with the players, and they've elected to take the power play, try to get it back one at a time.
Marhedic trying to do just that. Kevin Kenner's now on the ball. Darryl Duran in the corner. Lance Johnson, though, a good challenge, and Richardson will clean it up. Richardson now trying to come through. And Darryl Duran will face pressure from Kevin Sloan. And this wastes time, and this is what, of course, the American Conference wants to do. And then Sloan is fouled. So now, with a minute 24 left on the power play, the American Conference gets a free kick.
They've got a good man-down team on the American Conference. You got Kevin Sloan, who possesses a lot of speed. Michael Richardson, good speed. And in the back, you got Fernandez and Lance Johnson.
Sloan sneaking behind Wes Wade. He ends up under those boards. And now a free kick coming up for the American Conference. So suddenly, they're in a great offensive situation here, even though they're on the power or on the penalty kick. Souvenir ball has been thrown on the field, so Michael Richardson has to send that up our way. And now the restart. Carriage from the acute angle. And now National Conference trying to clear, but DeFloria puts it back to Pappas, and time goes off the clock. Richardson challenged by Duran. And I think Duran got his leg up a little bit too high there. So with a minute 7 left on the man advantage for the team in the red, it's the team in the blue, the American Conference, with possession.
The American Conference doing a good job of killing this penalty. One thing you don't want to do if you're on the power play is commit fouls, because it allows the defense, number one, to rest, and number two, they can retain possession of the ball. Now, Carriage here probably will have a go. When he takes this big a run at it, David, usually means he's shooting.
Carriage does just that, and it's collected by Finnerty. Finnerty, long ball field for Wes Wade. Wes Wade now, with Richardson on him. Wade keeping his body in between him and the defender. So 18-5 the score. 48 seconds left on the man advantage for the American Conference, but they've struggled, Art, on this power play.
Yeah, I'm sure Darryl would have liked to have seen a quick goal on the power play. Had the momentum just before the power play, but give the American Conference credit with their penalty killing.
Lance Johnson gets it behind the defense. This could actually work in the reverse with this. A bit of a slow start. In fact, the American Conference yet to score in the first 7 minutes of this third quarter. They may have the momentum after this power play if they can indeed kill it off.
The National Conference hasn't even taken a shot yet on this power play. There's 15 seconds left.
Rasmussen trying to slot it to Reiniger. He does, but Pappas closes the angle. And now, I believe we have a handball on Reiniger, so it'll be a free kick for the American Conference, and 8 seconds left to kill off, but they will have been successful in the penalty kill.
Good job by Pete Pappas in the nets to move his feet quickly and come out and make that save. Goalies not only need to be good with their hands, but they need to possess quick feet.
All right, even strength, so a successful penalty kill for the American Conference as Omid Damazi comes out of the penalty box. Richardson now comes out roaring, and Reiniger tracks back to collect for the National Conference. Here in the third quarter of this 1998 NPSL All-Star Game on Fox Sports Ohio on Fox Sports Net. R.O.B. Elevat plays it for Tom Ortiz, a Canadian influence now on the floor. Eric Rasmussen. We saw how silky he was when he scored a goal here in this second half. Biello, nifty flick, but his teammates didn't read it. Now the American Conference, they expended a lot of energy in that first half. Eurosport, the fabled soccer traders. They are presenting you this third quarter of play. 1-800-934-4876, the number for the best catalog in soccer. Eurosport, the fabled soccer traders. The restart for the National Conference. Otto Marhedic. Marhedic, West Wade coming through. Notice how much space the defender gives Marhedic.
And Paco, that time wasn't given a lot of space as he was pushed down by Knowles. And Matty saying, you all right? But the National Conference has to think. It's 18-5 now with 8 minutes left. Here you see the push once again. If they can get it back to 18-10 by the end of this quarter, they've got a chance.
Biello, it's in the net! It's in the net! Seven as Mauro Biello scores. The star from the Montreal Impact, as they like to say in Montreal, the Impact de Montreal. So Biello with the goal, and it's 7-0 here in the second half.
And Coach McWilliams, sensing a change in momentum, is going to take a timeout as Biello brings the national team back within 11.
18-7 our score, the National Conference with a surge.
We're at the Crown Center in Cincinnati, Ohio. It used to be called Riverfront Coliseum, but it's a beautifully renovated Coliseum now, home of the Cincinnati Silverbacks and the NPSL All-Star Game. I'm Greg Mace with you here on the bench. Of course, this town has great sports tradition. I want to give you a little history lesson, jog your memory, and take you back to one of the coldest moments in the history of the National Football League. It was Dave and Art.
All right, the professor Greg Mace, always with the history lesson. And, you know, it's amazing. I think 300,000 people were at that game, the freeze ball. I'm sure Greg didn't have any trouble finding someone that said they were at the game. Everyone is always at the game.
I tell you,
you were at that game, weren't you?
I was there as well.
Yeah, I seem to remember now. It's coming back to me. In fact, George Veris, our producer and director, was probably at the game. In fact, I think he was at the game. He may be the one person left in Cincinnati. The National Conference, they're in the game. Back in the game, they are trailing 18-7, but they've outscored the American Conference 5-0 here in the second half, Mark Barry.
Well, right now they're hot, Dave. They are hot. They've scored 3 straight goals. One thing we talk about in Milwaukee is making a run. And right now they're on a 6-point run, and they need to keep that going for the remainder of this quarter.
So 7-18 left in the third quarter. And again, if you look at that score, say, wait a minute, how could a team down 18-7 come back? Well, don't order a pizza, just keep watching, and you may see how it happens in the National Professional Soccer League. In transition, Kevin Ketters, Marhedic for the National Conference. Back to John Linyanis of the Montreal Impact. Into the corner for Todd Ritchie of the Edmonton Drillers. And now I believe we have an over and back violation. So again, the momentum stays with the National Conference. Again, the ball gone forward and Carrick's brought it back behind that yellow line.
Hotto's on the ball. He's not a real threat to shoot. He might run over and let Reiniger strike it.
Instead, he chips it going for Biello in the corner to head it down. And now the National Conference will keep possession with 6:42 left here in this third quarter. The 1998 NPSL All-Star Game. Todd Ritchie coming up with the challenge by Marinaro, slowing down.
And in the first half, Dave, it seemed like the American Conference had possession of the ball about 70% of the time, and it's totally the opposite here in the second half. The national team has possessed the ball the majority of the time.
Reiniger trying to win the ball, but instead, Matt Knowles digs in. Reiniger winning it back. Reiniger, we talked about him being the emerging star in the NPSL. Over 100 points this season again already. Daryl Durand. Biello. Reiniger for Durand, but Pappas is in position. Now the American Conference, who have yet to score here in the second half after exploding for 18 points in the first half. Second most ever in an NPSL All-Star game, but they've been shut out by the National Conference here.
Well, it's a natural tendency when you have a big lead to let down a little bit, and I think that's what you've seen here from the National, actually from the American Conference here in the second half.
And of course, it was Virgin recording artist Common Sense imploring the National Conference to never give up, and they've obviously needed that. But the American Conference quickly coming forward. Nunzio of the National Conference pokes it away. Now in transition. Forward now, a chance here. Rasmussen takes the shot, but the angle cut by Pappas.
Well, that would have been a big goal that time for the Nationals. Rasmussen, one of the best one-on-one players in the league, couldn't finish that time.
DeFlorio has a target. Hesch Nice ball to the box, but Wade intervened, but he was looking far post. Now transition again. Rasmussen, the shot saved. Pappas. And it will be a kick-in coming in for the National Conference.
Hey, you see Rasmussen coming in here this time, trying to go near post up. Just a little bit too casual in his finish.
From the top of the arc, the restart. Marhenik pointing directly, gives away, foot save, and the hot court ricochet comes back to Pete Pappas. Now quickly in transition, look at Finnerty all the way out. Knocks it forward, Rasmussen gets in position, gets behind the defender, taken down. We'll have a penalty and a shootout should be coming up here.
Now they didn't pull the blue card out on that one, Dave, as Rasmussen was in behind the defense. That's one of those where they may have, but elected not to. Once again, you see Demazi take down the legs, take out the legs of Rasmussen, but
DiNunzio the shot. DeFlorio, Gino DeFlorio trying to send it upfield. Marhenik intervened and prevented it from getting to Zoran Karic, who would have been 1v1 on the keeper, and he would have been free for the American Conference. 4:25 left here in the third quarter, a third quarter full of energy for the National Conference. That energy continues. Rasmussen take it down again, and there the card comes out.
Well, you do it once and get away with it, you're not going to get away with it the second time. That time, Chinapu from behind, and Rasmussen has given the American Conference defenders all they can handle. He's gotten in behind them about three or four times here in the last 4 minutes.
Eric Rasmussen. So Chinapu goes off for the two-minute tripping penalty. So a shootout here worth 1 point, and if they can convert here, it's within 10 points now. George Fernandez and Kevin Sloan in the forefront from the American Conference.
It's going to be Kevin Ketters this time taking it for the National Division.
Ketters, it's in the net. 1 point goal. So we have a 10-point game. Would you decline the power play here, Art, or no?
I don't think so. You've got yourself back within 10. There's still 4 minutes left in the third. I think you run the power play. You try to get it back to 18-9.
At that point, it's a three-point goal, a couple of two-point goals, and you're right there.
Well, it's three goals, three three-point goals in the tie.
All right, so man advantage for the National Conference. So if they score in the next 2 minutes, it's worth 1 point. Rasmussen. Lateef puts it out front to Marhenik. Rasmussen settles. Does he have a shot? He does. Skims off Pappas. National Conference, very organized power play. Wade the cross. Wade denied. Now Wade trying to create. Wes Wade of Kansas City slots it into the net. Reiniger the goal. And the National Conference. 7 unanswered points here in the second half.
Now Petey Pappas doing all he can to keep the National Division out. You see the initial save come out, but it was good off the ball running that time by Reiniger. Watch him free himself in the box, and Wade slots it past three players, the goalie and two defenders, to Reiniger. One more look at it. Petey cutting off the near side, but Reiniger with that right foot. He talked about his weak right foot before the game, but he knocks one in with the right foot on that one.
Well, Joe Reiniger, the emerging star in the National Professional Soccer League, one of the emerging stars in the NPSL, and he said he wanted to improve on their right foot when he talked in the pregame to Greg Mason. Well, maybe there it is, as you said.
And what was really neat on that shootout, people at home didn't see it, was Pato was going to take the shootout. He realized he'd already used his best move. The keeper had already saw it. Told Ketters, you go ahead and take it, and it paid off.
So 3:57 left here in the third quarter. 18-9 the score, and let's go downstairs to Greg Mace.
Well, with Kevin Ketters, who scored the goal right there before. Kevin, is a tied turn now?
I hope so. We're within 9 points now. Hopefully we can get a couple more goals before the quarter. We'll look good. I think we got to keep playing tight defense in order to keep them off the board and maybe get a couple for ourselves.
You feel like you guys have gotten your second win now?
Well, I mean, we're changing in twos. We don't have a lot of subs, so we're, you know, we just got to put away our chances. So as long as we put away our chances, I think we'll be fine.
They're certainly back in the game here, and the mood on this bench has also clearly changed, David Hart.
Well, it should, with a score now 18-9 at the National Conference. Is Joe Reiniger going down at the other end of the carpet just after scoring that power play goal for the National Conference? And of course, that's, no one wants to see an injury in an All-Star game. Never wants to see an injury, period, but especially in the All-Star game.
That time, Reiniger just stepped on the ball a little bit awkwardly, but I saw Michael Richardson come up to him, ask him if he was all right, and he shook his head, yeah, so.
Well, a lot of weight on that left ankle, and in the carpet, if you haven't played indoor soccer, it looks like he's okay, but you can get your foot actually caught in that carpet. So Reiniger with two goals tonight.
And part of the National Conference comeback.
With 3:25 left here in the third quarter. Again, as Greg Bates talked about, there's been some great fourth quarters in the history of this All-Star game. We could be setting ourselves up for another. Wes Wade behind the defense, and now the American Conference under that pressure again. Nolzall, great ball for King. And Brian Finnerty, great read.
Well, Finnerty almost playing like a sweeper in outdoor soccer, coming out a couple times already in this quarter. I tell you what, the Goose hasn't had to make many saves here in the third quarter, but he's done well coming out of the goal and using his feet.
Ryan Finnerty of the Detroit Rockers. So again, in indoor soccer, the ball is put in play from where it was kicked out. So that's why the American Conference will have the free kick from Marinero. Daryl Duran intervenes. Player coach of the St. Louis Ambush. And a foul on Hector.
Now we know Joe Reiniger is a big three-point shooter, Dave. Both of his goals today have been one-pointers. He's got a shootout goal, and he's got a power play goal.
And you mentioned that. He's got 11 three-point goals on the season. So that's a lot of three-pointers for Joe Reiniger of the National Conference. Again, Reiniger having a terrific season from the St. Louis Ambush with 124 points. Now to Marhedic for the National Conference. Again, they are the red, the American Conference in the blue. Marhedic stay with it. He gets called for the foul as he fouled George Fernandez. The home fans don't like that. Fernandez, the player coach of the Silverbacks of Cincinnati.
You heard Kevin Ketters just a moment ago talk to Greg Mays about the need to keep playing solid defense. You see Pato put down Fernandez there. A couple coaches, player coaches in the league. But it's interesting he would stress the defensive end with them down by 9 points. But good defense will lead to some good chances offensively.
And that's what it's done here in the second half, and also giving them some energy. Matt Knowles playing a ball forward for Marinero, and we see the defense, Biello's stepping up. But now Knowles finds Marinero, but they're keeping it out of the box. In the third quarter, brought to you by our friends, the fabled soccer traders at Eurosport. 1-800-934-4876 to get the Eurosport catalog from the fabled soccer traders.
See Bobby DiNunzio play that ball to his keeper and then make the move over to the left side. He's a left-footed player. He found himself on the right side in the back and made a good run to get over to his natural left foot.
National Conference trying to continue their comeback in the red jerseys. Ball for Reiniger. He's marked by George Fernandez. You see the one-on-one matchup. National Conference with so much possession here, they've been making the American Conference chase the ball and expend the energy that the National Conference expended in the first half.
Well, I talked earlier about them needing to get back to about 18-10. They're at 18-9 now. One more here before the end of the quarter would be a big goal.
Todd Rattie of the Edmonton Drillers will play it back to his keeper, Brian Finnerty. And great camera work. You see, you just saw what Finnerty had a look at as he tries to play it upfield, but Fernandez had that red. But now Duran with a steal, but I think Duran got called for the foul against Orrin Kerrick. So a free kick in midfield with 1:02 left for the American Conference. And we bring you inside. And boy, do we bring you inside. So Orrin Kerrick's coming right at us.
Soren saying, come on, this is an all-star game, Daryl. We talked about the pride of Duran earlier on in the game, and he's not going to stop playing, all-star game or not.
Well, he led the National Conference to victory last year, and he was the most valuable player with 4 blocks in that game. Reiniger, long ball upfield, looking for Marhedic, and takes a favorable National Conference skim, although now the American Conference. Michael King, got DeFlorio on the far side. King will take the shot. Finnerty with the save. 33 seconds left. Finnerty looking for Marhedic. Stepping up Reiniger. Marhedic now weaving, using the boards, and he gets tangled up with the American Conference defense. And George Fernandez. So Marhedic forcing the action and a foul on Fernandez.
And Marhedic's one of the best playmakers in the league on these restarts, and he's going to have a good opportunity here just outside the corner of the box. And Daryl's going to set it up and take a timeout.
All-star game competitive. Daryl Duran calls a timeout. You bet it's competitive. Daryl Duran wants to make sure they have the restart sorted out. 18-9, American with a lead on the National. And again, we talked about the American Conference. Let's look at the National Conference. Get you up to date where we are at this point in the NPSL season. Look at this division. Then Buffalo on top, but a good battle between Edmonton, Detroit, and Montreal.
Yeah, Edmonton got off to a little bit of a rough start, but they've come on as of late. Buffalo having a good year there with the Pickazinski brothers. They've won 6, 7, 8 in a row out there in Buffalo.
And the Midwest Division, St. Louis, Wichita, and Kansas City, all above 500 in this division.
Yeah, St. Louis regarded probably as the top team in the league right now. Best record in the league at 21-8. Coming off two losses this past weekend to Montreal. So great parity in the league.
Fox Sports then style. Take you inside. Let's go inside.
You got lost the thought. Why don't you let that?
Got it. You dummy right here. Sign the wall for Joe coming across.
The play drawn up on Cincinnati Silverback Stationery by Daryl Duran. And what'd you gain from that, Art?
Well, it looked like what they want to do is to pick the side of the wall. Daryl's going to come rope around to the top of the arc for the shot. It may be him or Reiniger with the shot. And if that's not on, you've got a guy that can improvise in Podomar heading. That's why they call him the magic man, because he can make something happen out of virtually nothing. But look at 21 here, Reiniger.
If he could tee up a three-pointer with 24 and a half seconds left. Reiniger will tee up the shot. And that went off Richardson. Reiniger again, and Pappas the same.
Great play by Michael Richardson that time to take one for the team. Step out, be brave, and block that shot.
Now, that didn't feel too well, I would not imagine. In transition now, Richard Chinapu, and he's got a shot. Infinity smothers as time running down. And with 2 seconds left, that may do it for the third quarter. So we go to the fourth quarter. The first half belonged to the American Conference. The second half has belonged to the National Conference. The fourth quarter will decide it as we continue with our coverage of the 1998 National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. Eurosport, the fabled soccer traders. By Kendis, the official soccer ball of the NPSL. And by Stromkin Supports, be like the pros. Dave Johnson, Art Kramer, back in Cincinnati, 18-9 the score. American Conference with the lead on the National Conference. We go downstairs to Greg Mace.
With Joe Reiniger, Joe, this has really not only been an all-star game, it's also been an all-star game of endurance.
Yeah, we're short some players, so we only got 2 rotating on the whole team. It's been a tough game, but we only got 1 more quarter. We're going to give it all we can.
You had a goal there earlier. What's been the difference for you guys now in the second half as you've dominated on the scoreboard?
Well, we're playing sound defense, and then we're counterattacking, and we're getting some good opportunities, and some of them this half are going in.
And a wonderful tribute again to the town of St. Louis and great soccer fans out there, and you got family back there watching. It must be fun for them to see you in the All-Star game.
Yeah, it is. My mom and dad were going to come up. They found out I was going to be on TV, so they decided to stay home. And I just want to wish my daughter, Jordan, a happy birthday. She's going to be 4 on Thursday. So happy birthday.
Joe, good luck in the second half. Tough test of endurance for these guys. They're changing every 2. We'll see what happens fourth quarter, Dave.
All right, and we extend a happy birthday to Jordan Reiniger as well.
And Joe's brother, Rich, was a player for the St. Louis Ambush a couple years ago.
Soccer family, but there's a lot of soccer families in St. Louis. In fact, my broadcast partner, Art Kramer, part of that St. Louis soccer tradition. 14:56 left here in the game. 18-9, the American with the lead on the National Conference. American Conference, Hector Marinero gets the shot off. But the National Conference, what a story in the third quarter with 7 unanswered points.
Well, they need to keep it going. They need to get the next goal here. If they do, they're right back in this one.
And the National Conference working on doing just that. Reiniger on the ball, slots it. But Pete Pappas was there. And look at Finnerty getting involved. Brian Finnerty jumping up, knowing that there is time left, but they want to take advantage of their chances.
Not only jumping up, but a tremendous first touch to bring that ball down out of the air.
Lance Johnson now for the American Conference. Zoran Karic. Karic weaving around the Giannis. And the shot, Marinero! Todd Routine digging it out nicely and very cleanly away from Marinero. And it's the National Conference in transition. Wes Wade trying to leave it. Instead, Knowles intervenes. He wanted to get it to Biela. Now Knowles. Knowles putting on some moves, though, to create the space.
And he played 2 games this weekend. This is his 3rd game in 4 days. Getting a little bit tired out there.
Mario Biela now for the National Conference, and they keep possession. They trail 18-9, but I think at halftime, a lot of people probably thought this was over. The ball played for Marhenik, slips behind the defense. Marhenik, ricochet, no one making the run.
Once again, that's that unfamiliarity with the players around him. Marhenik that time playing the ball off the boards. DeNunzio had made the run to the back post.
Kevin Sloan doing well to control it in midfield. Now Gino DeFlorio, the shot! Whistled through Brian Finnerty's gloves, but went wide. DeFlorio, of course, of the Silverbacks, the host team for the 1998 NPSL All-Star Game.
Yeah, the home crowd would love to see Gino DeFlorio get one. Gino having a great season thus far, 121 points.
Ricochet too hard off the boards, and now Kevin Sloan. Sloan springing DeFlorio, Finnerty is out. The footwork, very well done. Now Duran back to Finnerty. And Duran gets it to Kevin Ketters. King, though, puts the pressure on. 12:22 left. 18-9, the American with the lead on the National. Richardson in transition.
See, the American, no points scored in the second half after they lit it up for 18 in the first half.
And that's never happened in the NPSL where we've had a scoreless quarter in an All-Star game. We've had two tonight, the first quarter for the National Conference and the third quarter for the American Conference. So it's been very much a game of momentum surges, and then right now belongs to the National. But Zoran Karic, he can change things, pokes it through. DeFlorio! And that one headed to Riverfront or Synergy Field. We are in Cincinnati, Ohio. And of course, all the big stars coming to the indoor soccer action this winter, including Boomer Esiason. That's right, Boomer's Hero is a big promotion this week to benefit a great cause. Boomer's Heroes Night with the Cincinnati Silverbacks coming up. And Mia Hamm, of course, a great national team player and star of those perked hair commercial ads. She was at the Detroit Rockers game.
And March 13th, Dave, in Milwaukee, Brett Favre is going to be there at halftime, and it'll be 17,000 strong in Milwaukee at the Bradley Center for that one. They love their football in Milwaukee and Green Bay.
And of course, in Milwaukee, one of the original members of the National Professional Soccer League, competed in each of its seasons, so that's a great indoor soccer city as well. Milwaukee Wave. Right now it's Rasmussen of the Wichita Wings, also a great indoor soccer city. Rasmussen on the ball for the National Conference. American Conference with the lead. Get the view from Jamie Swanner on that National Conference bench. 18-9 the score with 10:44 left in the fourth.
And there needs to be a sense of urgency right now on the side of the National Division. Down by nine still, just over 10 minutes to play. They need to go forward and take some people on.
Wes Wade trying to do just that. Ketters comes up to help out. Now Rasmussen. He's great one-on-one. Rasmussen, the shot, it's in the net! It's in the net! It's in the net! A goal, Erik Rasmussen!
Well, Erik Rasmussen was a star for the Wichita Wings in the late 80s. Took 10 years off from indoor soccer, and he's showing people that he can still play. We talked about the need to start taking some players on offensively. There you saw it. Rasmussen, great individual talent, beats Chinapu on the dribble, and then beats Pappas to the right side.
Rasmussen with the goal, and now the National Conference within 7 points, 18-11. The American Conference with the lead, at least for now, on the National Conference. Go inside North America's premier indoor soccer league with Shootout Magazine, the official magazine of the NPSL. Three issues a year for $5.50. Call 1-330-455-4625. Score a goal with the NPSL. Apply today for your official NPSL MasterCard. Call 1-800-523-7666. Get your favorite team's logo on your official NPSL credit card. 1-800-523-7666. That lead that once was 18-2 is now 18-11. And I think really would help trigger to the National Conference tighten up on defense.
Well, we heard Joe Reiniger talk about it early in this quarter. They needed to keep playing good defense. They've done that.
Michael King intervenes, and now the American Conference trying to step up. DeFlorio, marked by DiNunzio. Kevin Sloan, the American Conference key possession. American Conference fully aware they get a goal here. The momentum is stifled, at least for the moment. Matt Knowles wheeling up the field, and he's a defender that can really go forward, and he does. The ricochet, not too much for Kevin Sloan to get to. Biello tried to thread it to Marhenik, but Richard Chinapu too cagey for that. Look at the view of Richard Chinapu using the target of Michael King. National Conference with four behind the bar.
And you saw the American Conference running off of Kinger.
It's in the net. A goal, American Conference. Michael King. So King at the crowd with a goal.
Well, that right corner's been nice to Michael King tonight as he's fouled it three times. Watch again, the first time actually takes a touch with the sole of his foot. And then just banks one off the far post.
It looked like a lot of traffic in front of Pete Pappas. Pardon me, Brian Finnerty.
Well, the Goose hasn't had to make many stops, and that time Kinger with the hat trick.
So the first score for the American Conference in the second half makes it 20-11 with 8:58 left here in the fourth quarter. Look at Hector Marino. And that's the first score since 13:58 in the second quarter. The goal, of course, going to Michael King. Now the National Conference trying to get back. Rasmussen trying to get it to Durant. Rasmussen steps up. Now Wade, he's tripped by Nemazi, and a free kick coming up here for the National Conference.
Now the Nationals going to make a change and get Pato Marhedic on the field for this restart. And watch again the foul. Nemazi is flipping down Wade from behind.
Rasmussen takes it. Rasmussen again. That'll be a goal kick coming up for the American Conference with 8:47 left. So Rasmussen getting over that one, but that one's safe.
Well, Pato ran on the field to go on the ball, and Rasmussen was already on the ball. And I'm sure Pato was telling him, just get in the shooting position, Button, I'll find you.
Again, Rasmussen, a great story, 37, returning to indoor soccer, playing in Brøndby in Denmark. It's a club that qualified in Europe. The ball for Richardson, the save by Finnerty with the feet. Zoran Karic for the American Conference. Karic with John Lemionis of the Montreal Impact marking him. Lemionis giving him some respect. Karic, so deeking, shooting, save.
And Zoran is showing some of his one-on-one abilities that time as the American Conference players all cleared out and let Zoran go 1v1.
That may be an over and back violation. Yeah, Zoran Karic, he always wants the ball. And when he has it, he can put on a show. And sleek player, both in appearance and the way he approaches the game.
And he's going to take that big run at the ball on the restart, which normally means he's shooting.
Well, that's how it's restarted the game. It was a three-pointer on a restart from Karic. There it is, blasting through. This time they paid for it in the wall. Oh, the shot by Marinero! Almost shades of 93, almost got up for the bite, a side volley.
Well, he promised it in the pregame interview. He said it may be a bicycle kick. There it was, but credit Goose Finnerty with a great save. Watch Hector get up. He's got a flair for the dramatic goal in All-Star games.
The side volley, Finnerty the save. But in the 1993 NPS All-Star game, one of the great goals in indoor history by Marinero. Marinero on the restart. Les Wade, though, now for the National Conference. 3-on-2 in the making. Biello, though, has trouble controlling it. And the American Conference gets back. Rasmussen. DiNunzio makes a run to the corner. Watch the dancing of Rasmussen. He attracts three markers. And he draws the foul and a free kick for the National Conference. Rasmussen, watch the crowd he draws.
Yeah, the dancing Dane, Eric Rasmussen. See Hesch come from behind, and that, once again, another restart. This time, Pato will go on the ball. And he's telling Rasmussen where he wants him.
Marhenik, he looked like he was chipping for far post. Dale Duran was there. Rasmussen, oh, flick to Marhenik, the shot! Skims across the goal line. And now Brian Finnerty will step up the goalkeeper. With 7:13 left here in the fourth. Wes Wade now for the National Conference. The ricochet comes out hard. Rasmussen controls. Daryl Duran, the player coach. George Fernandez, another player coach.
A few of them out here tonight. Marhedic, Fernandez, Duran.
Not only your coaches and players, but all-stars in the NPSL. Kevin Ketters. Bursting forward, Ketters, the ricochet, Ketter, save by Pappas.
Well, that would have been an indoor soccer goal. Off the boards to yourself.
Rasmussen, and no, the goal, Ketters, Kevin Ketters. Kevin Ketters makes it 20-13. And the National Conference now pulls back to within 7 points with 6.5 minutes left.
Well, that's a mark of a good goal scorer. You don't score the first opportunity, but you don't quit trying. He gets in good position at the back post. And that time, Rasmussen's initial shot's blocked, but Ketters in perfect position at the far post. Once again, look at Ketters down low, working the box, back and forth, and beautiful position that time.
20-13 to score, NPSL All-Star Game. Back in the crowd in Cincinnati, 7,298 here tonight. And the crowd, a great crowd for the National Professional Soccer League All-Star Game. Our score of the American Conference with a 20-13 lead on the National Conference. And this is a wonderful facility that the Cincinnati Silverbacks and Cyclones of the IHL International Hockey League have renovated here. It's bringing a lot of people back to downtown Cincinnati. And they hope to have the International Hockey League All-Star Game here as well. And they certainly have shown that they are deserving of it, with or without a gorilla. You need a gorilla, right?
Phoenix has a gorilla. Yeah. Cincinnati's got a gorilla.
Right. A silverback gorilla, though. It's a specific type of gorilla. In case you're wondering, we mentioned the nickname of the hometown team, the Cincinnati Silverbacks. It's in reference to a gorilla that is at the Cincinnati Zoo. I didn't see that on Animal Planet. I actually read that. Dave Johnson, Art Kramer, Greg Mace back here in Cincinnati. And the National Conference playing like they're on another planet in the second half. They have really rallied here. They have outscored the American Conference 11-2 in the second half. But the American Conference with a 20-13 lead with 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
This is where you need to take some chances, let some three-point shots go. We've only seen one three-point goal, and that was the first goal of the game by Carriage off the restart.
In the National Conference of the red jerseys, Joe Reiniger for the St. Louis Ambush. The American Conference in transition. DeFlorio. DeFlorio knocking it forward. King making the run, but Brian Finnerty has come out. He gambles a little bit, but you have to gamble at this point if you're the National Conference. The American Conference trying to get possession back. Pressure by Reiniger on Chinapu, but he is so cool at the back. Richard Chinapu. Now Kevin Sloan starts the attack. Sloan, the shot, he took it up! That's it! Kevin Sloan!
And a good turn by Sloan that time. And nice ball to put it out in front of himself, and they just let the right footer go just inside the three-point arc. And Goose had his hands on that one. Probably a shot he'll tell you should have stopped, but not going to stop them all. You see Sloan once again.
Kevin Sloan of the Philadelphia Kicks. And Brian Finnerty. Competitive indeed. 22-13. The American with the lead on the National.
You see Sloan, he's got that cut on his nose. He was telling me before the game he was warming up with Omid Nemazi and a halogen lamp fell on his nose.
Trying to explain that. Eric Rasmussen knocks it in the box. Biello in the back heel. Now Duran dancing. Biello whipping Rasmussen in the corner. Into the net. Biello. Mauro Biello. That ball had salsa on it.
Well, Mauro Biello and Bobby DiNunzio played together last year in Buffalo with the Blizzard. Biello now with Montreal. Receives a nice pass off the boards. Look at Rasmussen. Draw the goalie down. DiNunzio off the boards. And Biello at the far post. Textbook indoor soccer goal.
Mauro Biello scores. It's 22-15. National Conference back with it. 7. We go to Greg Mace.
Well, it's a scoring frenzy. Kevin Sloan had the goal before that one. Now 22-15 in the last 4 minutes. You guys still are not in a comfort zone where you can sit back.
No, we're not. We're not in a comfort zone. It just seems like after